stand up to the program, ladies and gentlemen. This woman is Kathy Raynall from Stamford, Connecticut, and she's joining us down here for tonight, and we're happy to have you here, Kathy. And anytime you want to jump in on this, please do. My next guest is a very busy fellow. He will be debuting on Broadway. That's hard to believe, isn't it, this guy on Broadway? He is also, that'll take place in the springtime, he is also co-starring in a new film called My Breakfast with Blassie. Please welcome Andy Kaufman.
Over, Kathy?
I'm sorry. That way we can talk. That's all right, Andy. If you can come. This is Kathy Raynall from Stamford, Connecticut.
Hi.
Yeah. Andy, you have something in your... what have you brought out here?
Kleenex.
Kleenex? And why is that exactly?
Because I'm just getting over a cold.
Yeah. Everybody that I know in New York is presently not feeling well. Mm-hmm. And you have a little... some sort of...
Someone gave this to me as a present. They put it in the box, so I never throw out presents.
Uh-huh.
So I keep it in.
Yeah. Yeah, well, this will last a lifetime. You'll want to hang on to that. Now, Kathy and I were musing over the fact that it's hard to imagine you in a Broadway play, but I guess you're going to be on Broadway, huh?
Yes.
Tell us about that.
Well, the name of the show, it's called Teaneck Tansy, and it's a comedy, and it's opening April 14th at the Niederlander Theater on Broadway.
Uh-huh.
It's on Broadway.
Is this a legitimate thing?
Oh, yeah, it's a legitimate Broadway show.
Yeah. You're not... no wrestling in this?
Actually, I'd it's hard to... No, I don't know.
You can't
I'd
talk
rather
about
not
it.
Give any you of it away
right.
yet.
But you're serious, it will be a Broadway play. Okay.
But it's a comedy, and it's a very enjoyable...
You're going to be the star of it?
Well, I'm in it.
You're in it. Okay.
I'm in it.
Now, let's move on to this other project, your film with Freddie Blassie, My Breakfast with Blassie. What is that?
That's a film, it was inspired by a film called My Dinner with Andre. It's where two men eating dinner in a restaurant, a French restaurant. So this is a film about myself and Fred Blassie eating breakfast in Sambo's in Los Angeles.
Uh-huh. And how did you meet Freddie Blassie to begin with?
Well, I've been a fan of his for many, many years. I used to watch him. He used to be a world champion wrestler, and now he's a manager of wrestlers.
Mm-hmm.
And I was watching him for many years in Madison Square Garden and on television and on the wrestling shows. I was a big fan of his, so I met him very briefly, but then I was approached by his manager and or management, and they said they wanted to make this film called Breakfast with Blassie and asked me if I was interested. I said, well, yeah, and that meant that I would get to meet him, you know, and talk with him, and it was a real great thrill to do that.
Now, again, is this a real film, or
oh,
is this something you show at parties at your house?
Oh, no. No, this is a film that's going to be available very, very soon in video cassettes in the stores, and it's going to be shown, from what I've been told by the producers, they're going to be showing it in midnight movies in revival houses.
What about airplanes? Would we see this on airplanes, for example?
I don't know. I just know that the producers are trying to, you know, they told me that it's going to be sold into revival houses, and it's a cult film.
It's a cult film. Well, that's good.
And it's going to be on cable TV.
All right. Now, we have a sampling of My Breakfast with Blassie. We're going to take a look at that now. You need to say anything about this, or should
well,
we just...
Well, yes. This is a clip from when Blassie and I... Fred Blassie and I walk in, we're first sit down
first,
to order.
First going into Sambo's in Los Angeles. All right, so we'll take a look at this. Watch the monitors here in the studio. Kathy, you can just, this one will work up here.
That okay?
Thank you.
What are you thanking him for? He didn't do anything more thanking that he wasn't supposed to do. Just showed us to our table. You don't have to thank him, he didn't do anything. Yeah, well, you don't have to be that nice. This looks like a drawing thing for a little kid. Doesn't look like much of a menu. You hungry?
Yeah, I need today.
Same here. All I've had was a glass of cranberry juice.
I just had a glass of water.
Glass of water?
Uh-huh.
Really saving money.
You know, there was a leak in my house, so I couldn't take a shower. I couldn't do anything.
You're kidding.
No. I wake up. I just went to the shower. There's nothing coming out. The guy came to my house, changed some kind of a water tank. He made a mistake, and there was water spurting out all over the street.
I mean, you're a big, you know, you're a big celebrity. I mean, you don't have to live in a rattle Hello, honey. What do we got here? Looks like we got two people waiting on us. You and someone else. What nationality are you? What nationality are you?
Thai.
You're Thai? Yeah. I was over in your country, Bangkok, but I never seen a pregnant Thai girl before. Come here. I always like to rub like a Buddha. Good luck. You're welcome. Don't have to tip her so much when we leave now.
What a smooth guy. Freddie Blassie. Andy, why don't you introduce Mr. Blassie?
Okay, well, he's the five times the world heavyweight wrestling champion. He's known as the King of Men, as the manager of champions, and most of all, he's known as the Hollywood fashion plate of wrestling. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Fred Blassie.
Freddie Blassie.
Freddie, how are you? Come here, Kathy. Don't run off just yet. Freddie, how are you? This is Kathy Raynall. Fred Blassie, nice. Kathy Raynall. We'll get an extra seat out here, and we'll be right back after you take a look at this, folks.
Presenting the Fisher-Price Pick Up and Go Vacuum, a new family member that will smile every day, be extremely entertaining, and pick up after itself, too.
It's moistened by the mist and sweetened by the sun. The Kalapuno coconut is the favorite coconut in paradise, and only one thing can top it. Bounty, Kalapuno coconut topped with milk or dark chocolate.
From Hidden Valley comes a delicious way to give up fat and cholesterol. Take Heart. Take Heart salad dressings. The good-for-you dressings that taste great from Hidden Valley. And now Take Heart introduces Lush's new Honey Dijon Ranch. Sweet, tangy, rich, and creamy, yet low in fat and cholesterol-free. So indulge. New Take Heart Honey Dijon Ranch.
So you want to be a cook. Let's start with the basics. This is an oven. Make it shine.
Unlike other oven cleaners, fume-free Easy-Off is heat-activated.
He forgot the gloves.
So you can forget the gloves and the harsh fumes.
I don't smell anything. What is that?
Whipped cream?
But turn on the heat, and it's anything but gentle on grease.
Not bad, kid.
Easy-Off. Fume-free or heavy-duty. The easy way out of a dirty oven.
Just the Wanderers. We've got to stick together.
The end of innocence.
You hear me? I'm talking to you.
Was only their beginning.
You gonna rumble or something?
Yeah, we want to fight.
Nuts, man. Get it.
There you go again. Hurting our feelings.
It's us against the world.
Ken Wall and Karen Allen find growing up hard to do.
If you ever need us, whistle out. We'll be there.
When they are...
Wanderers forever.
The Wanderers. Saturday on A&E.
Welcome back to the program, ladies and gentlemen. Freddie Blassie is here. Andy Kaufman is obviously here. And Kathy Raynall is here. And Freddie, this is a... tell me about that suit you have. That's interesting. That's a very colorful...
I figured being on your show, I wouldn't wear anything that was too loud.
Oh, that was thoughtful of you.
Very quiet and subdued.
Uh-huh.
But I have about 35 different outfits that I wear in the Madison Square Garden, Philadelphia Arena, Boston Gardens, and... wherever I appear, I never wear the same outfit twice.
Okay. Now, let me ask you this. What did you think of Andy's wrestling ability when he was active in the ring?
We can talk about something nicer. I told Andy when he start wrestling, he should stick with women because he's not qualified to wrestle men.
Yeah.
And he proved that by getting his neck hurt.
But when you were wrestling, Freddie, you were a pretty brutal guy. We have some photographs here of you in action now.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, what is this?
That's a wrestler there. I used to file my teeth. In fact, I was the only wrestler that ever did that. I had my teeth capped, and I'd file them. They were razor sharp. And
why did you want your teeth razor sharp, Freddie?
So I could bite the guys. And as you can see...
But that's not real blood, is it? This is stage blood.
That's something I've never seen before.
But, you know, look at you. You don't have a mark on you.
Well, that's because I used to dish it out before they could.
Uh-huh.
I admit I'm good-looking and handsome. God's gift to women.
Now, this says 48 stitches. What does that mean? Is that the guy?
48 stitches, that's right. That was Don Carson out in Los Angeles.
All right, and here, now this.
That is Black Dortman. He was the heavyweight champion of Mexico.
Oh, now this is...
That's right.
No, this is just a little showbiz. This is a little razzle-dazzle
here, isn't it, Freddie? Now, let me say, now if you want me to do the same thing to you, I can do it right here on TV.
Oh, no. We have a guest here. I would hate for Kathy to see that.
Kathy's all right.
Now, when you wrestled in Japan, I came across an interesting statistic. Something happened to people who came to see you wrestle in Japan.
Yes, it was 1962, and it was right after they had shown a series of movies over there, and TV had just been initiated over there in Japan, and they showed a group of vampire pictures. And the Japanese people at that time were very... squeamish people, I don't know, very weak-hearted, faint-hearted, and I used to bite the guys over there, and 25 people dropped dead during my six-week tour.
No, again, wait a minute, Freddie. 25 people actually
stopped
breathing,
dead, ghosts, vapor. They were sitting in their chair, and the people, they thought they were sleeping, and went over and touched them, and as they touched them, they keeled over.
I mean,
they were dead. D-E-A-D, Kathy, with a capital D.
Do you believe this, Kathy?
Well...
Wait a minute, Freddie. Do you believe what this man's saying?
I'd question that.
Yeah, I would.
I think we should question that.
Well, I'll tell you.
Lee Bailey here.
Let's put it this way.
Okay, wait a minute. You can have Lee Bailey or anybody else.
But it was in Newsweek magazine.
25 people passed on.
That's right.
My
ambition in life was to kill 100 people, and I failed. Only made 92.
I'm sorry you had to hear this, Kathy. We'll,
92.
Station identification. And then we'll be back.
I don't just dust my furniture. I give my wood the royal treatment. With Old English Oil, it seals in wood's moisture to help prevent drying and cracking. Give your wood the royal treatment with Old English.
It's moistened by the mist and sweetened by the sun. The Kalapuno coconut is the favorite coconut in paradise, and only one thing can top it. Bounty, Kalapuno coconut topped with milk or dark chocolate.
My dad had ulcers, so when my stomach started acting up, I was afraid to go to the doctor. But finally, I went. Was I relieved when my doctor said my Lanta? He said it was indigestion, not an ulcer. And my kind of indigestion called for a strong medicine.
Mylanta is strong medicine. Strongly recommended. In fact, Mylanta is the antacid doctors recommend most.
My doctor said Mylanta.
And try Mylanta's Mylocon. It has the best medicine for gas. Behind every Progresso label is a little bit of home. Progresso blends the finest ingredients and seasonings to give all our soups true homemade flavor, then adds the distinctive Italian touch that makes them Progresso. Great homemade soups take time and care, and that's just what you'll taste in every bowl of Progresso. For all the flavor of home, make it Progresso, or make it yourself.
Not just white.
Really white.
Not just white.
Really white.
When you want whiter white,
still going,
nothing outlasts the Energizer. They keep going and going
Take a close look at Prego spaghetti sauce and Ragu Old World style.
Stop the film. Forget about close. This is obvious. Prego is thicker. See, right here and right here. Big chunks. Ragu Old World style is thinner. Just say Prego. It's in there.
Right.
Bringing families together is what AT&T is all about. So for the 20th anniversary of Walt Disney World, we created the AT&T Family Reunion Sweepstakes. Win magical vacations, round-trip tickets on Delta Airlines, or free AT&T long-distance calls. To enter, dial 1-800-641-2000. The call is free, but the memories are priceless. Only for you, only from us. Call now.
Spellbound Perfume from Estee Lauder. Now a special Spellbound gift is yours with any Spellbound purchase. This exclusive offer is yours at Bloomingdale's.
We understand that over the course of a year, there might be a month or two when you'd like to skip your credit card payment. Which is why with a Chase Manhattan credit card, you can skip a payment on whatever month you choose. We're flexible, and that makes for a better experience with us all year round. Chase. Profit from the experience.
All right, welcome back to the program, ladies and gentlemen. Kathy, do you want to read this?
Pardon me?
You want to read this? Just read the blue card there and
just
see what happens. If you don't mind, that would be great.
The second half billboard coming up in the second half hour. Alba Ballard and her costumed parrot. We have a parrot at home.
Do you have a parrot at home?
Yes.
Do you ever dress your parrot up?
No, can't say for that. He'd probably like that. Uh-huh. NBC Spurts.
Spurts?
Spurts commentator, Marv Albert. He has a C-R-T-S.
You guys hear that? Okay.
Did that say Spurts, S-C-R-T-S? Yeah.
That's right, we have a Spritzcaster coming up later. Tomorrow, comedian Richard Lewis and Rockette Pam Kelleher, viewer mail and actress Mary Beth Hurt will be with us tomorrow night. Freddie, what are you and Andy, now you've been in a film together, you're not going to be in the play with Andy, are you?
No.
Yeah. Do you have any future projects we could look forward to?
You tell them, Andy.
Well, we're going to be remaking Sons of the Desert. It's an old Laurel and Hardy movie. And
This guy laughs at everything you see.
And we haven't started shooting yet, but we've started rehearsing.
Rehearsing you and a recreation of the famous team of Laurel and Hardy.
That's right.
Yeah. What could you do a little?
You've got us into a fine mess again, you pencil neck geek.
But Fred, I
don't. Will you cut that out, you pencil? Yeah. Here you come on again. Stuttering again like you always do. I told you when you talk to me, come right out with it. Don't be afraid to talk. Now you're talking. Now you're crying again. You hear that pencil neck geek crying again? You're crying. Listen. Do you ever see a grown man cry? And I'm supposed to do a skit with this pencil neck?
So that's yeah. Well, I know people will look forward to that coming to their nearest theater. Now, is it true that you're also managing Andy's career now, Freddie?
Yeah. I'm managing his career as an entertainer, not as a wrestler, because he proved to me that he's not a wrestler.
Mm-hmm.
But as an entertainer, he's great.
Yeah.
He can out-sing Bing Crosby, Perry Como, Elvis Presley. In dance, he makes Fred Astaire look like he's got two left feet. Keep quiet, I'm talking about you now. I'm handling you, and I only handle the best. I've got Big John Studd, Crippler Stevens, and I've got Ivan Koloff. Nothing but the best. Yeah, and now I'm handling you. Now you've got the finest. Will you keep quiet? I'm not bragging. I'm telling the truth. Why don't you get over there and show the people how you can sing? I'm sure that... I know you can't sing with a punk band, but I'm sure that those pencil neck geeks over there, especially the guy with the chili dipper over there, you know how to play jambalaya, don't you? Jambalaya? Go over and sing. When I tell you to sing, you sing. Get over there and sing. Come on, get over there.
That was the stupidest thing I've ever seen in my life.
Only goes to prove you don't know good talent.
I just want to say one thing.
No, no.
David, I didn't want to sing.
You didn't. Okay.
No.
You didn't do your best.
I didn't want to sing.
We'll be right back. Alba Ballard is here, fortunately, for all of us, and she brought along her costumed apparel.
Well, Bobby, she don't bird.